Bond scissions or fragmentation reactions are another kind of chemistry that can be induced by light. In some instances, these bond fragmentations resemble elimination reactions, like the beta-elimination reaction, and at the end of this webcast, we'll see an example of such a photoelimination. The primary photo product of photoelimination and photofragmentation reactions are a variety of very reactive intermediates like diradicals or sviterionic intermediates. Also generated are electron-deficient species such as carbenes and nitrenes. What normally happens, once these intermediates are generated, they undergo a variety of secondary thermal processes. In many instances, photofragmentations involve the loss of small molecules such as carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, or oxygen. We'll classify these fragmentations according to which bond, relative to the position of the chromophore, undergoes cleavage. For example, in the case of alpha-cleavage, we'll be talking about a bond adjacent to the chromophore. So if the chromophore is a carbonyl, there are two possible alpha positions that could undergo cleavage. Exposure of light of the carbonyl group generates this diradical species that we've seen before. Homolytic fragmentation of that leaves a pair of radicals, which will undergo subsequent thermal processes. Alpha cleavage in the case of the diazoalkane is just a little bit different, but it's analogous to what we just saw. There's only a single alpha bond relative to the diazo group, and so that's the bond that's going to undergo fragmentation by alpha cleavage. We can represent the excited state as a diradical species that's shown here. Homolytic fragmentation of that now generates a 6-electron carbon that is neutral. In other words, we've generated a carbene with the loss of dinitrogen. Photo-induced beta cleavage is possible if there's an acceptable leaving group attached to the alpha carbon. In general, these processes can be viewed as a type of beta elimination. Let's take the carbonyl as our example. One bond removed from the carbonyl chromophore would be the beta bond, and if X is a suitable leaving group, then it's possible for a photo-induced beta cleavage to take place. Here's how the process might look. We've seen that one representation of the excited state of the carbonyl is this sviterionic form in which the carbonyl carbon bears the lone pair and the negative formal charge, and the oxygen is an electron-deficient species. Now we can imagine a beta-type elimination reaction where we take the lone pair and we move it onto the alpha bond, and in doing so, we kick out the good leaving group, X minus. That generates a species that's shown here. The carbon-carbon double bond can be viewed as being in resonance with the carbon-oxygen double bond to generate a carbocation on the alpha carbon position. This highly reactive carbocation is capable of undergoing subsequent chemistry. In the example shown below, the Photo-Wolff rearrangement, this atom will become a carbene species. The Photo-Wolff rearrangement involves the alpha-diazo ketone functionality. An important resonance contributor of that functional group is shown here, and it's very clear that we have an excellent leaving group attached to the alpha carbon. The way the Photo-Wolff rearrangement then might take place would be to imagine an excited state in which the carbonyl chromophore takes on this sviterionic form. At that point, we could use a beta elimination, that lone pair, kicking out molecular nitrogen, dinitrogen, to generate a carbene structure that's shown here. Again, we can see that carbene by moving the carbon-carbon double bond in resonance with the carbon-oxygen bond to generate a carbonyl group and the carbene functionality. This electron-deficient carbon is capable of undergoing a 1-2 rearrangement. A phenyl migration will take place by a sigma to a pi type interaction, leading to the structure that's represented here in this sviterionic form. A more familiar way of representing this resonance contributor can be seen by moving that lone pair to the carbon-carbon bond position, and now we have the resonance contributor of the ketene functionality, the product of the Photo-Wolff rearrangement.